Good day, everyone. I'm here to report to you the first half of Chapter 14, Project Management. Project management is the process of using information, skills, tools, and procedures to complete tasks with predetermined budgets and timelines. Planning the work, evaluating risk, estimating the resource needed to complete the work, organizing the work, obtaining human and material resources are some of the parts of project management activities. Project is a deliberate set of associated tasks intended to accomplish a certain business goal. Information systems projects might involve creating new systems, improving current ones, or upgrading or replacing the organization's information technology infrastructure. 5 factors of project management for information system. First is scope. It determines what work is and is not included. For instance, the scope of a project for a new order processing system might not involve any changes to the corresponding accounts receivables, manufacturing, distribution, and inventory management systems, but rather, new modules for entering orders and sending them to production and accounting. Next is time. The length of time necessary to finish the project. The time needed to finish the main parts of a project is often determined by project management. The goal of project management is to estimate the time needed to finish each activity and provide a schedule for doing so. Third is cost. Calculated by multiplying the time needed to finish project by the price of the human resources needed to complete the project. The price of workspace, software, and hardware are all included in the cost information systems project. The project's budget is created by project management, and ongoing project costs are tracked. Fourth is quality. A measure of how well a project's final product meets the goals set forth by the management. The effectiveness of information system initiatives is typically measured by how well they facilitate decision-making and organizational performance. Last is risk. Risk describes potential issues that could jeopardize a project's success. By raising time and expense, diminishing the quality of project outputs, or preventing the project from being completed entirely, these possible issues may prohibit a project from reaching its goals. The most significant information system risk considerations are discussed in management project risk. These are the consequences of poor project management: cost excess, time lapses, technical issues affecting performance, and getting less than expected benefits. Without effective management, system development projects take longer to finish and frequently end up costing more than originally planned. The resulting information system is almost certainly less sophisticated technically and might not be able to offer the organization any advantage. The systems created by unsuccessful information initiatives are frequently not used as intended or are not used at all. In order for these systems to function, users frequently have to create parallel manual systems. The system's actual design may fall short of capturing crucial business needs or enhancing organizational effectiveness. Information may not be sent quickly enough to be useful. It might be presented in a way that makes it difficult to understand and utilize, or it might reflect the incorrect types of data. Here are the components of management structure for information system projects. Each level of management in the hierarchy is responsible for specific aspects of system projects, and this structure helps give priority to the most important system projects for the organization. The corporate strategic planning team is in charge of creating the company strategy plan. which can necessitate creating new processes. This group frequently chooses to sponsor IT projects that can significantly improve one or more key performance indicators because they have devised objective measures of firm performance. The company's board of directors examines and discusses these performance indicators. The senior management team in charge of system development and maintenance is the Information System Steering Committee. It is made up of department heads from the Information Systems and End User Division. The Steering Committee evaluates and approves plans for systems in every division, works to coordinate and integrate systems, and on occasion takes part in the decision-making process for picking certain information system initiatives. The project team is managed by a project management team made up of end user managers and information systems managers who are in charge of managing a number of distinct information system projects. Linking systems project to the business plan. Organizations must create information system plans that support their entire business plan and incorporate strategic systems into top-level planning in order to identify the information system projects that will provide the greatest commercial value. The plan acts as a roadmap for system development, detailing the reasoning, the state of systems, and the situation at hand. Any new developments to be taken into consideration, the management strategy, the implementation plan, and the budget. The strategy outlines the organizational objectives and how information technology will help those objectives to be achieved. Portfolio analysis. It can be used to assess different system projects after strategic assessments have established the general direction of systems development. The organization's information systems projects, assets, infrastructure, outsourcing agreements, and licenses are all inventoried as part of the portfolio analysis. This information systems investment portfolio has characteristics of risk and benefits to the company that are comparable to those of a financial portfolio. Each information system project has its own unique mix of advantages and disadvantages. By balancing the risk and return from their systems investments, businesses would strive to increase the returns on their portfolios of IT assets. There isn't a perfect profile for every company, but information-intensive businesses like finance should have a few high-risk, high-reward projects to stay on the cutting edge of technology. Businesses in non-information-intensive sectors should concentrate on high-profit, low-risk initiatives. Naturally, solutions with a high benefit and low danger are most ideal. These guarantee low risk and quick rewards. Second, it is important to investigate high benefit, high risk systems. Avoid low benefit, high risk systems at all costs and re-examine low benefit, low risk systems in case they can be rebuilt and replaced with higher benefit systems. Next is scoring model. It is helpful for choosing projects when various factors need to be taken into account. It weighs the individual components of a system before calculating the weighted sum. The business must choose between two alternative enterprise resources planning solutions. The decision maker's evaluation standards are listed in the first column. The decision-making group typically holds lengthy conversations to determine these criteria. The agreement on the evaluation criteria is frequently more significant than the score when using a scoring model. Using the scoring model involves making several qualitative judgments, as is the case with all objective methods. Experts that comprehend the problems and the technology are needed for this model. Information system cost and benefits. Costs are hardware, telecommunication, software, services, and personnel. The tangible benefits can be quantified and assigned monetary value. Systems that displace labor and save space, like transaction and clerical systems. Intangible benefits cannot be immediately quantified but may lead to quantifiable gains in the long run. And systems that influence decision-making, such as collaborative work system. Whenever possible, management information systems, decision support systems, and computer-supported collaborative work systems are outperformed by transaction and clerical systems that eliminate labor and free up space while also producing more quantifiable, noticeable benefits. Capital budgeting for information systems. Measures of cash flow into and out of the company are the foundation of capital budgeting techniques. Capital projects are the sources of the cash flows. Hardware, software, and human cost results in an immediate cash outflow, which is the investment cost for information system projects. The investment may result in more financial losses in succeeding years, but this will offset by cash inflows from investments. Cash inflows can be achieved by increasing sales of existing products or cutting expenditures associated with operations and production. The difference between cash inflows and withdrawals is used to determine an investment financial value. Several other strategies are available for assessing projects and selecting the investment once the cash flows have been calculated. Real option pricing models. Not all of the benefits of making investments can be predicted in advance, even though its expenses can be determined. However, if the company waits a few years for the revenue potential to become more apparent, it might be too late to invest in the infrastructure. Managers may find it advantageous in these situations to evaluate information technology expenditures using real option pricing models. The idea of option valuation, which is a notion adapted from the financial sector, is used in real option pricing models. Essentially, an option is the freedom to take action at a later time without being required to. For instance, a typical call option is a type of financial option in which a person purchases the right but not the duty to buy an underlying asset at a definite price on or before a specific date. In a manner similar to stock options, ROPMs value information system projects whereby an initial investment in technology creates the right but not the obligation to benefit from further development and deployment of the technology, so long as management retains the flexibility to cancel, defer, restart, or expand the project. And that's all for my report. Thank you for listening.